Lieutenant Christopher Sharp, Fairfax County Police Department, Incident Support Services.
We use our dogs in a peer support capacity, and that could be working with victims of domestic violence. That could be going to the courthouse prior to a court case being heard. But we also use at community events. We take the dogs to Special Olympics. We take the dogs to National Night Out. We take the dogs to community meetings to kind of talk about our program, what we're doing to help our officers, and what we're also doing to help the community. We go out with the dogs as much as we can to any kind of a community event, especially ones that we're asked to come to. After the initial introduction of the dogs that we did, went through social media, went through all the news networks, we had an abundance of places calling us, not only about our program, but wanting us to visit so we could showcase the dogs and what we're doing for the mental health and wellness of our officers. So when we developed the program, we had to get approval from our Board of Supervisors and obviously our county attorneys, because you're bringing a dog into a police station or a police building, and people have allergies, some people are scared of dogs. So with our program, initially we had a 2-year pilot program with the organization that donated the dogs to us. So we were there as volunteers. Everyone on our peer team volunteers to handle the dogs. We don't get paid for it. We do that because it's peer support and that's what we want to do. But the organization donated all the training, medical care, food, everything that we needed for the first 2 years. A lot of agencies sometimes will go to organizations that already have a fully trained dog and either purchase a dog or see if they can get a dog donated. The only really stumbling block that we had, because we wrote policies stating that every station, every police facility had to have a room available for the dogs just in case somebody's scared, just in case somebody had allergies. And the only stumble that we thought we were going to encounter was someone being allergic to the dogs. And people that were allergic to the dogs said, "I'll take more medication, I don't care." The introduction to the dogs, even when they were little puppies, just immediately won everybody over. And to this day, we haven't had a single complaint about the dogs, except for a lack of productivity sometimes, because you bring a dog in the office, nobody wants to work, they only want to play with the dogs. Our program, we specifically decided that through our policy, the dogs were only going to be assigned to peer support officers. The only issue that we had as far as peer support, and the dog was assigned to a peer support member, is that they couldn't be in patrol. And the reason behind that is we couldn't have an officer in a patrol cruiser running lights and siren, or having a prisoner in the car and having a peer support dog too. Our patrol officers are kind of tied to their CAD. And when they're dispatched to calls, they don't really have time to be able to, you know, take a dog to the police station, drop the dog off, and go, you know, run hot to a call. So we purposely decided that all of our peer members that could train the dogs had to be in every position except for patrol. We had a critical incident when the program was fairly new, where a traumatic incident occurred at a house. And there were a lot of children that witnessed that event. I was the supervisor for peer support on call with Jack. He was a little over 3 months old, and we responded to the event. Of course, the idea again was to train the dogs to be service dogs. And that is where I saw the value of having a dog in-house. You have officers that responded to that incident, and they are not only dealing with multiple casualties, but they're actually, you know, they're dragging bodies out. They're standing over bodies. And when you get back to the scene being cleared and those officers coming back to the station and, you know, the investigation occurring, people talking to detectives, our psychologists there, and our peer support members there, you see the value in an officer that just witnessed something so traumatic taking a 5-minute break to pet a dog. And it really does work. If they can take their mind off of that incident that they had to deal with for the last 2 hours, that's what we're looking for. That's our in, but that's also allows us the ability to talk to that person, because what we don't want is someone to deal with a traumatic incident and set those walls up and not talk about it and keep it inside, because that's where things go bad. And introducing that dog, whether it's trained or not, even if in the early stages of training, proved to me the value of having a dog internally for our officers after they witness something traumatic.